Hello all, in the previous session we have discussed about the propagation of the TM wave through waveguide. Now today we'll discuss about some of the basic parameters of the waveguide. We'll start with the cutoff frequency of a waveguide. So we'll talk about the cutoff frequency of a waveguide. So, and this waveguide will be considered as a high pass filter. ठीक है? So we'll say that waveguide as a high pass filter. So when I say the waveguide is a high pass filter, this means that the cutoff frequency of a waveguide is nothing but the minimum frequency which my waveguide can allow to pass. So previously we have seen that h square is equal to gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon is equal to a square plus b square, and we know that a is nothing but the m pi by a and b is nothing but the n pi by b. So if I put all these things over there, I can say gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon is nothing but the m pi by a square plus n pi by b square. So if I am interested in the gamma right now, how I can write the gamma? My gamma is equal to gamma square. I am interested right now in the gamma, so I'll just say gamma square is equal to m pi by a square plus n pi by b square minus omega square mu epsilon. ठीक है? Now here, whenever we talk about the gamma, or if I want to say only gamma, if I am interested in the only gamma, I will take the square root of this whole term. So this will become square root of m pi by a square plus n pi by b square minus omega square mu epsilon. So these things we have already seen. I have just put it the values of everything over there. Now what will happen at the lower frequencies, or you can say I'll take the condition whereas at lower frequencies what will happen. So at a lower frequency, at a lower frequencies my gamma is not propagation constant, whereas my omega square mu epsilon here at lower frequencies will be less than m pi by a square plus n pi by b square. What will happen in this particular condition at the lower frequencies? If I am saying that my omega square mu epsilon is less than m pi by a square plus n pi by square, so this value will be less than this one, and whatever I'll get is nothing but the negative value. So my gamma will nothing but the, I can say a real value, and you can say here if this value will be less, I can say lesser than this one, I can say gamma will become real and positive. ठीक है? So if omega square mu epsilon is less than m pi by a square plus n pi by b square, if this value is less, you can directly subtract from this particular value. So here you can say gamma is equal to positive and real. So if my gamma is positive and real, I can say my propagation will not be there. So what is the condition there for the propagation? If we revise some of the things which we have seen in the previous sessions, we can see to have a propagation my gamma must be imaginary. So gamma is nothing but the alpha plus j beta. So if this is real and positive, no propagation will be there. So gamma positive means no propagation. If it is real, there is no propagation. If gamma is equal to imaginary, you can see the equation. If gamma is equal to imaginary, that j beta, you can say there will be the propagation. So this is the condition which we have seen in the previous sessions. So whenever you say your omega square mu epsilon is less than m pi by a square plus n pi by b square, your gamma will become real and positive and equal to the attenuation constant. ठीक है? Now what will happen at the higher frequencies? Now we'll consider the another condition, whereas you're assuming that your frequencies are higher. So however, at higher frequencies, you can say, so however at higher frequency, I can say my gamma omega square mu epsilon will be greater than m pi by a square plus n pi by b square. Now here your gamma becomes, here I can say my gamma becomes imaginary. Now my gamma is imaginary, and if this is the imaginary, you can say there will be the phase change beta, that is beta is nothing but the phase constant, alpha is nothing but the attenuation constant. So you can say there will be a phase change, and if there will be the phase change, I can say there will be the wave propagation, and hence wave will propagate. Your wave will propagate from there. So I can say this wave propagation will be there. Theek hai? Now we are assuming that our waveguide it just started passing our frequencies. The propagation just starts. So here when we are talking about propagation just starts, means we are considering whatever frequency is there is nothing but the cutoff frequency. So we will consider or we'll assume something like this. So you can say we say gamma, theek hai, becomes zero. So I'll say gamma becomes zero and propagation just starts. So if you say your gamma is zero and your propagation just starts, means I can consider this particular frequency as a cutoff frequency. Theek hai? So the frequency at which gamma just becomes zero is defined as the cutoff frequency. So I can say f is equal to fc, that is my frequency is the cutoff frequency here. Theek hai? Gamma becomes zero and propagation just starts. So I can say f is equal to fc. Gamma is equal to, I can put gamma is equal to 0, or omega is equal to 2 pi f, or you can say 2 pi fc, because our assumption is that your propagation just starts, your frequency is the cutoff frequency, is equal to omega c. Theek hai? So whenever you talk about the cutoff frequency, you can say propagation just starts. I'll write gamma is equal to 0, so I'll revise my previous equation that my gamma square is equal to m pi by a square plus n pi by b square minus omega c square mu epsilon. ठीक है, तो ये हम लोगों ने पहले देखा हुआ था. जस्ट पुट एट वैल्यू ऑफ ओमेगा एज ओमेगा सी एज वी आर कंसिडरिंग दैट योर इक्वेशन जस्ट और योर प्रोपागेशन जस्ट स्टार्ट्स. सो ही आर रीअरेंजिंग द टर्म्स, वी कैन से ओमेगा सी, अदरवाइज आई पुट गामा इज इक्वल टू जीरो फर्स्ट. सो जीरो इज इक्वल टू, सो जीरो इज इक्वल टू एम पाई बाय ए स्क्वायर प्लस एन पाई बाय बी स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा सी स्क्वायर म्यू एप्सिलॉन. ठीक है, अब रीअरेंजिंग द टर्म्स वी कैन से दैट ओमेगा सी स्क्वायर म्यू एप्सिलॉन इज इक्वल टू एम पाई बाय ए स्क्वायर प्लस एन पाई बाय बी स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज समथिंग विच वी हैव गॉट राइट नाउ. ठीक है, नाउ अरेंजिंग द टर्म्स अगेन ओमेगा सी स्क्वायर. ठीक है, सो वन अपॉन mu epsilon, here as this is multiplied, this will be the division over here. I'll write m pi by a square plus n pi by b square. Further solving the equation, I can say this omega c, as we know that omega c is nothing but the 2 pi fc. ठीक है, so if you rearrange the term, you can say here that 2 pi fc, the whole term square is nothing but I will find out the square root of the both sides, so I'll put all these things in the square root. So I can say 1 upon square root of mu epsilon in the square root of say m pi by a square plus n pi by b square. So this is under square root of these things. ठीक है, और इसका पूरा square root हो जाएगा, तो ये वाला term. ठीक है, further solving this equation, again I am going to solve this equation as I have taken the square root of the both sides. Now I can say आपका जो 2 pi है वो वहाँ पे चला जाएगा, तो fc is equal to 1 upon 2 pi mu epsilon, and then the whole term will be say m pi by a square plus n pi by b square ka square root raised to 1. So this is what we have got after solving the equation. So fc is equal to, now we know that, as we know that what's the cc is equal to 1 upon root mu epsilon. So I can put that value over here. So I can say c by 2 pi is nothing but the m pi by a square plus n pi by b square ka square root. ठीक है, raised to 1 half. So fc here will become c by 2, as I can say m pi square, I can take 1 pi out, so I'll say pi square will be something like this. So here pi pi will get cancelled, m by a square plus n by b square and the whole term square root. So further solving this, I can solve this equation like this. So here I have got f is equal to c by 2 and this particular thing. So I'll either you take a square of this one and after that square root of this one. So c by 2 m square b square plus n square a square divided by a square b square. So this is what I have got after solving this equation, and I can say my fc is nothing but this value. So I'll write here fc is equal to, I'll write the whole term like this, square root of this things and c by 2 out, and I will say m square b square plus n square a square divided by a square b square. So this is what I have solved for the cutoff frequency. Now as I have got the cutoff frequency, we are interested right now in the cutoff wavelength. So how you can calculate the cutoff wavelength based on this formula? So here going for the cutoff wavelength. So we know that the cutoff wavelength can be defined like this. So lambda c can be given by this formula. So lambda c is equal to c by fc. Now we got that fc previously. So c divided by, I can write whatever we have concluded previously, that c by fc. So fc is nothing but the c by 2 square root of m square b square plus n square a square divided by a square b square. So further solving this, I can write cc will get cancelled, 1 by 2 means 2 will get here. Theek hai, agar a square root ke bahar aayenge to ye aa jayega twice of ab, and in the square root you can write m square b square plus n square a square. So this will be the lambda c. Theek hai, so cut off wavelength for your, say you can say waveguide is nothing but the twice of ab divided by m square b square and n square a square. Now what we'll discuss, what do you mean by a and what do you mean by b, as we have already dealt with the waveguide. So if I am drawing this waveguide like this, agar aap waveguide ke bare mein baat kar rahe ho aur agar aap ab ke bare mein baat kar rahe ho, so this is nothing but the waveguide. So this is waveguide, the rectangular waveguide which will have this kind of the structure. So this side will be denoted by a and this side will be denoted by b. So if you know the a and b, and if you know the mode of operation, so if I am talking about the mode 1 1, you can put the value of 1 and 1 over here and you can solve this lambda c. So this is all about how we can find out the cutoff wavelength and how we can find out the cutoff frequency. So here again I am writing how we can go for the cutoff frequency. So it is c by 2 in the square root. So in the square root, instead of in the square root, I'll write here a b aapka agar bahar aata hai to twice of a b, here m square b square plus n square a square. So this is all about how we can go for the cutoff frequency and the cutoff wavelength. So today we'll stop here, and in the next session probably we'll talk about the wavelengths. So thank you.